Welcome back for a second lesson on cofunction identities. In this video, we'll be solving trig equations involving cofunction identities. Let's take a look at our first example. We want to find a possible acute angle solution to cosine of the quantity 2 theta plus 16 degrees equals sine of the quantity theta plus 11 degrees. As I mentioned in the previous video, most textbooks give the cofunction identities in the form given here in blue, but they can also be expressed as sine A equals cosine B if angles A and B are complementary or have a sum of 90 degrees. So this is true if A plus B equals 90 degrees. It's also true that secant A equals cosecant B if A and B are complementary or have a sum of 90 degrees, and tangent A equals cotangent B, again, if A plus B equals 90 degrees. So just as in the previous video, we're going to use the identities highlighted in blue to solve these equations. So the first thing to recognize here is that we have an equation where we have cosine of a quantity equals sine of a quantity. Therefore, these angles must be complementary or have a sum of 90 degrees. So we want to solve the equation 2 theta plus 16 degrees plus theta plus 11 degrees must equal 90 degrees. So now we'll go ahead and solve this by first combining like terms and then solving for theta. So we have 2 theta plus 1 theta, that's 3 theta. And then we have 16 degrees plus 11 degrees, that's 27 degrees. And this sum must equal 90 degrees. So now we'll solve for theta. We'll start by subtracting 27 on both sides of the equation, or 27 degrees. So now we have 3 theta equals, this will be, what, 63 degrees? Now divide both sides by 3. We have theta equals 63 degrees divided by 3 is equal to 21 degrees. This would be one possible acute angle solution to the given equation. Now let's take a look at a second example that involves radians. Again, we first need to recognize we have an equation where we have cotangent of an angle equals tangent of an angle. This cofunction identity here, and again the main thing here is that these two angles must be complementary, or in this case, must have a sum of pi over 2 radians. So here we'll have theta plus the quantity theta plus pi over 6 must equal pi over 2 radians. Again, we'll combine like terms and solve for theta. So we have 1 theta plus 1 theta, that's 2 theta, plus pi over 6 must equal pi over 2 radians. Next step, we'll subtract pi over 6 radians on both sides. We need a common denominator, which would be 6, so we'll multiply this by 3 over 3. So now we have 3 pi over 6 minus 1 pi over 6. Well, 3 pi over 6 minus 1 pi over 6 is 2 pi over 6. So we have 2 theta equals 2 pi over 6, which is going to simplify. That's going to simplify to pi over 3. So let's go ahead and change that. Now, instead of dividing by 2, because we have a fraction over here, we're going to go ahead and multiply by the reciprocal. So we'll multiply by 1 over 2, or 1 half. So on the left side, we just have theta, which we're solving for. On the right side, multiply across the top and bottom. Theta is equal to pi over 6 for one possible acute angle solution. OK, that's going to do it for this video. I hope you found this helpful.